today we're on the Shenandoah. I'm hoping that we'll get enough fish to look at. So far today, we only have four. One male, three females. When we were looking at fish that were involved in the fish kills, we found the intersex accidentally, first in the south branch of the Potomac in West Virginia, and then here in the Shenandoah in 2004 and 2005. Our interest is, are the same chemicals that are causing intersex also leading to the immunosuppression we're seeing, and that's leading to fish kills? You can't really tell intersex fish by looking at them, so you really have to cut them open, take pieces of the testes, and look at that microscopically. What we see is immature eggs within the testes of the male fish. I would have thought that we'd see intersex at a much higher prevalence downstream of major metropolitan areas. And a lot of times, at least in this area, that's not the case. Most of the work that had been done was focusing on wastewater treatment plant effluent, so human influences. In more recent years, we're focusing on agricultural sources. The fact is that many of these things are coming from our lifestyles. One of the hopes is that best management practices and those sorts of things going on, upgrades to wastewater treatment plants, that will also reduce the hormones or estrogenic compounds that are causing the intersex.